Good morning. Today we are again going to see deeply about the law of construction. The Ravi Che and Company Union of 2018-6, Supreme Court 2010. There the judgment is pertaining to arbitration. The law of interpretation is there, but this judgment may be quoted for civil suit, domestic violence, family court, EP, etc., etc. Because the basically to bring arbitration, there should be a contract between the parties. Only on agreed contract the arbitration clause could be invoked. Here under clause 16(3) of the contract, there is a prohibition for awarding interest on earnest money, security deposit, and upon amount payable to the appellant. But the arbitrator still pendente lit means pending inquiry or trial or litigation, whatever it may be. Pendente lit means pending litigation. So before awarding, award means pendente lit. As soon as you file an application, claim for application before the award arbitrator, that you commence the litigation. Therefore, pending litigation, the arbitrator awarded cost. But the reason which was given by the arbitrator has been upheld by the Supreme Court, because the claimant has been found entitled to the damages and has been kept out from those days due to the pendency of arbitration, that means pendente lit. Therefore, instead of awarding interest, they awarded interest because there is a reason for damages. They say, unless agreement expressly bars an arbitrator from awarding interest pendente lit, it does not bar an arbitrator who is never party to the agreement from awarding it. This is the words they have used. Unascertained damages determined in the course of arbitration. So you after obtaining a loan, you are deliberately denying the payment, legal payment, and goes on protracting the cases, trial. Then if there is no interest clause, still the arbitrator can award damages in the term of interest. So you kindly go through the judgment, that will be helpful. Then and then another thing for law of interpretation, new words are being used. Commissioner of Central Excise versus Madan Agro Industries, 2018, 4 Supreme Court 692. This you have to understand. See, rules for interpretation and the chapter notes. So while understanding law of interpretation, we have guidelined to look into notes, head notes, aim and object, preamble, object of the act, parliamentary discussion, all these things. There here they say CBEC, harmonized system of nomenclature, and the chapter notes, explanatory notes, they are to repeatedly acknowledged by the Supreme to be safe guide. The Supreme Court says a dispute may also arise on a claim that though the items falls within a particular heading, if it falls in particular heading, the tax will be different. Therefore, this resulted the litigation. Some of the same item may fall under another heading of the same chapter on different chapter altogether. All dispute with regard to classification of goods, manufacture and cleared has to be primarily decided and resolved within the framework of the Act and are the basis of rules for interpretation and the various chapter notes, supplementary notes contained in the tariff act. Therefore, understanding of the CBEC and other authorities exercising jurisdiction under the act may be reflected in the circulars, memos issued from time to time. So, circular, memo, all are law under Article 13, under Article 12. Then, the harmony system of nomenclature, again it is repetition. Kindly go through this. Then another important case for which I would like to, then pith and substances. Pith and substances. It's always correlated to law of inconsistency, occupied field, and pith and substances. So while comparing or scaling whether central act would survive or state act would survive, the pith and substances of the purpose of the act must be looked into. They say Justice K.S. Pattuswamy vs. Union of India Supreme Court 2018-7, page 129. When an enactment is challenged on the ground of legislative competency, that means whether a state legislature has got competency or the central government has got competency, the doctrine of law will be valid if it in substance it falls within legislative entry on which legislature is competent to enact law. This is the core subject you have to answer always in the law paper, pith and substance. Then again, the new Oklaw Interstate Development Authority versus Chief Commissioner of Income Tax 2018-6, Supreme Court 345. Then what is fiscal statute? This is a fist. If you show your fist to any shopkeeper, he will definitely give you the money. Like that, sovereignty, the king, sovereignty, dictator, monarch, whoever being a sovereignty head of the, he imposes tax. He snatch something you have earned for the benefit of maintenance of country, you save you from aggression of the enemies, as well as to give social need and social reformation, rehabilitation to the society. That is the duty of the state. They say fiscal statute, strict construction. So it should be in favor of the sovereignty. That means sovereignty means government. A person invoking an exception or an exception provision to relieve him from the tax liability must establish clearly that he is covered by the said provision. Suppose you claim that this under these provisions, I have a right to exempted, exempted from paying tax, then it is your duty to death. They say, Novo Pan case, 1994, Supplementary 3, Supreme Court, SEC, 606. That case has been referred here. Then again, another case, Shanti Bhushan versus Supreme Court of India, through its registrar and another 2018-6, Supreme Court 304, where they have referred Article 124, wherein the appointment of judges being managed by collegium, 1 to 5 judges collegium. Then they say under 145, allotment of the duties, then they say Shanti Bhushan has claimed the Supreme Court that even that transfer, posting, allotment of the cases should be within the collegium competency. But again, law of interpretation, they have deeply discussed. Then they say, second judge's case, first judge's cases, second judge's cases, so many cases pertaining to this recruitment of the judicial officers, and Supreme Court still exhibiting adamancy, not implementing Indian judicial system because they want to maintain hierarchical inheritance and dominance to the post by the same sect of the people, again and again, ignoring the grassroots competent advocates being elevated, and I have seen that who do not have basic qualifications are being elevated only on the political ground and by lifting the hands by their relatives. That is a different thing. You see, in this judgment, this is, say, we have seen beneficial interpretation, strict interpretations, but here, convenient interpretation. Convenient interpretation, interpretation for mass satisfactions, all RR nowadays being introduced. The Rama Janmabhoomi judgment, even Lord Rama may not like that judgment, because the land were given as an arm, not as a matter of right. That is different. Then here also they say, in collegium, the Chief Justice consult all the five judges. It was possible. Normally meets intervening period, but so far 145 posting, Chief Justice alone could do that. Therefore, the entire power is vested with the Chief Justice. This is what, why this Shanti Bhushan has filed this application was, deliberately they allot certain cases to particular judges. And nowadays that has been dropped. I have experienced in Madras High Court, whenever the judges retires, a convenient portfolio is being given. One judge from Karnataka was allotted at the last period of his retirement. His son is being engaged, and both amassed wealth. This not only that, Karnataka, even our Tamil Nadu judges also benefited by this. These all are happening. Best wishes.